Okay, here comes, suppose this band has been rehearsing for a year in the Himalayas in this mansion, you know, all with sports cars and everything they want, you know, and then you drop them down in the Fillmore in some unsuspecting club, and they walk out there, everyone's, it's not going to be a visitation of the gods, it's going to be like, who are these cats? If there was a millionaire heiress and she said, okay, I'm going to be the patroness of a band. This is going to be, and this band is going to be, I'm going to set them up in a mansion up in the mountains. They're going to have everything they've always wanted. They're not going to have any economic hassles. They're not going to have to fuck with any of these people. Just make their music. You know what you get? A lot of shit. One of the horrors, but also one of the great beauties of capitalism and free enterprise is that somehow coming from nothing and struggling and contending with all those things somehow makes you more knowledgeable and more aware and stronger in a way. You know, I was hoping, I'm not sure I was hoping, but I thought there might be a possibility it would become a major case, some kind of groundbreaking case, but it didn't turn out that way. There was no possible way I could have received a fair trial. Ideals at stake.
They never really proved anything except profanity, which we admitted all along, that there was profanity used in the performance. And we were going to attempt to prove that that did not violate contemporary community standards in the city of Miami. And to do that, we were going to take the jury to see a lot of movies, like Woodstock, and Hair was playing in town at that time. They were just trying to hang me, you know.
This is a theatrical performance, nonetheless. It's not a political rally.
Actually, I was charged with, I don't even know if they said incitement. I think it was giving an immoral or indecent exhibition or something like that. Anytime we try to break out of that bound of passivity, our actions usually seem awkward and obscene, like an invalid that's forgotten how to walk.
The basic American issue of freedom of speech. The First Amendment provides, supposedly, for freedom of expression. And there's a clause of it which states that any dramatic or public artistic performance comes under this amendment, which guarantees the right to say anything you want to without fear of being prosecuted. The right of a dramatist to, or an artist to state his views without coming under legal pressure.
I guess it was a valuable experience because I think before the trial I had a very unrealistic schoolboy attitude about the American judicial system, and my eyes have been opened up a little bit.
Basically, what they refuse to listen to any testimony. The right of anyone with a personal viewpoint to state their ideas in public and receive a hearing without legal pressure being put on. The origin of freedom of speech, and which goes side by side with the origin of drama, actually.
Jim Morrison, singer.